With the release of Mastercam 2023, the Unified Multiaxis toolpath is superseding the Morph, Parallel, Along Curve, and Project Curve toolpaths. This change simplifies the Mastercam Multiaxis product, making it easier for new Mastercam users to choose the right Multiaxis toolpath. This change may leave experienced Mastercam users wondering, how do I make a Morph toolpath now? Let's build a Unified Multiaxis toolpath on the docking ring. Select the 6mm ball mill and go to the cut pattern page. We can first select our drive surfaces, shown in pink. Let's focus on replicating a Morph Between Two Curves toolpath first. Select the curve input type and click Select. I'll hold Shift and click here to select all tangent edges, once for my from curve and once for my to curve. Notice how the entity counter here shows two curves in this one pattern row. In the style dropdown, we see parallel, perpendicular, project, and guide, but no morph. Let's move forward with guide for now. On the tool axis control page, choose from point and select this point. Now click the apply button to see a toolpath preview. With two chains selected, guide curve creates a toolpath that closely resembles morph. However, the options in these fields aren't the same as what we'd expect with Morph. We'll talk more about these differences in a later video. In previous versions of Mastercam, users needed to select from and to geometry for Morph in different selection sessions. The same is true here. To maintain clear from and to curves, we must make two curve input rows. Let's delete our single pattern strategy and activate two curve rows. With two rows, Morph appears in the dropdown. If we added a third row, the morph option would go away again. Having two rows here also helps Mastercam 2023 convert old morph toolpaths into Unified Multiaxis. Now we can select the same two curves, one for each row. The options in these lower tabs now match what we'd expect to see for morph. Let's change the stepover calculation to exact mode and click apply to see a toolpath preview. We now have a perfect morph toolpath. The morph strategy must adhere to some rigid rules, creating lots of clicks for the user. As you can see, the guide curve option is much more flexible and efficient. One further shortcut available to us here is the automatic cut pattern option. Remove the cut pattern strategies and click Automatic. In the Style dropdown, we see the option called Machining Boundary Morph. For this specific case, our morph curves lie on the boundaries of our machining area. This cut pattern strategy automatically makes the curve selections for us, removing the need to select any chains at all. Now, click OK to generate the toolpath. Something that makes the automatic method extremely powerful is its ability to react to model changes. Let's use Model Prep to delete the backside fillet here. By deleting this fillet, we'd be deleting an edge curve that we used for guide or morph. If we had used guide or morph, we would need to reselect this curve to regenerate the toolpath. With the automatic strategy, we can simply regenerate the toolpath and the edge curves will automatically update. We could achieve a similar toolpath by using surfaces as our cut pattern input geometry. Remove the automatic cut pattern and choose surface. Notice how the first option in the style dropdown here is guide. The same lesson as before applies here. We can select two surfaces in one row to create a guide surface toolpath. Guide surface would resemble morph between two surfaces, but with some new options. Or we can create two rows of surface inputs to create a true morph between two surfaces toolpath. Unified Multiaxis does a great job of replicating Morph, but with the introduction of the Guide option, Unified Multiaxis easily outperforms it.